Excuse me.
Hey, do I know you?
Mr. I believe we've met.
We have?
At that ghastly party.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. To be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
As my people, if we are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties. And those treaties were broken. And we've been moved and punished and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, it will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
Well, it's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal it?
Obviously, they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in 2 states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, an appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his. No.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.
Bonjour. real problems.
So, welcome to our humble police house. What can I do for you? Can I help you with something?
Chief, I'm representing the inventor of a humane execution machine. An electric chair. And he wants to demonstrate his invention here.
Ah, I'm familiar with the man and his work. Tell you what, I'll give you a permit. But it's gonna cost you $100 in fees.
Hey, look, this will save you money in the long run. And, it'll save the condemned a whole lot of pain.
That remains to be seen. But I'll give you a permit for 50.
Okay. Well, the price is fair. Here you go.
And here, sir, is your permit. Pending the usual formalities, of course, such as finding a suitable candidate for humane dispatchment.
I'll tell that to the professor.
Good luck.
Doing all right? If you want me to keep that overnight, there's room in the stable. That works. Wish more folks took care of their horses like you.
Hello, Professor... Professor...
Andrew Bell III.
That's it. So, the chief says you can test out your machine, pending the usual formalities.
And what are they?
Finding a suitable, subject.
Ah, funny you should mention. And this fella here, he seems sturdy enough, and he's guilty of sin.
Wilson J. McDaniels, wanted for murder, bigamy, and immoral animal husbandry. What's that?
The mind shudders. Here, find him for me, and help me put him out of his misery.
Yep.
Hold up. Sorry if I cut short a fun dream. We've arrived.
Appreciate the ride. See you around.
someone here.
Treat for you.
God damn.
Take me to damn court, then. This ain't America. We ain't free, no.
Sounds like sour grapes. You know, you ain't going to court. You ain't going to jail, either. I'm taking you to a professor I know.
What in hell are you talking about?
You're a lucky man, mister. You get to be part of a great experiment.
Shut up!
You ain't gonna die needlessly, is what I mean. Nope. Your death's gonna be an important step in the advancement of human knowledge.
What in hell you saying, mister?
This professor, Andrew Bell III, I believe he said. He's a little odd, maybe harebrained, but I got no reason to doubt the quality of his work.
What's this damn professor got to do with anything?
Well, he wants to try this new electricity chair on you. To kill you. Humane.
No!
Yeah. Well, he's gonna strap you into this contraption and run a large electric current through your system. Got something to do with moonshine. Don't quite know what. I guess that's why he's a professor and I'm the bounty catcher. Well, as I said, I can pass on his assurances that this is a most humane way to go. It'll be just like, well, like switching off a light.